Hey, it's Kai, and today for Autism Awareness Month, we're going to be talking about autism tics and what they are or aren't. This video is going to be doing some moderate to in-depth description of autism and Tourette syndrome and tics. I am going to be assuming that you have at least a little bit of base knowledge of what those disorders are. I am going to be making citations in this video, and as I make those citations, they'll appear along the bottom of the screen with a number and the article name. You can use that information to find the link to the article that I'm citing down in the description below. Autism tics are not really a thing. Just to lay a bit of background, tics are repetitive movements that are involuntary or semi-voluntary, caused by developmental brain differences. They're a very specific type of movement disorder. About 20% of kids at some point will have a tic disorder, and they'll have tics that last for less than a year. 1 to 2% of the population will have chronic tics that last for over a year and are typically lifelong. There is a pretty prevalent misconception that autism spectrum disorder can cause tics as one of its symptoms. This is not the case, and there's several different factors that feed into this misconception. The first one is that autism spectrum disorder comes with its own set of involuntary movements called stereotypies. Stereotypies are officially described in the DSM and autism research as being involuntary movements, though many community members describe them as subconscious or semi-voluntary than truly involuntary movements. These are commonly referred to as stimming, and they are complex motor movements, things like flapping both hands, wiggling both your fingers, swaying back and forth, or bouncing in place or spinning in circles. And again, these are called complex motor stereotypies, and they're included in the autism diagnostic criteria as one of the restricted behaviors used to diagnose autism spectrum disorder. They can be easily mistaken for tics, especially because they outwardly look pretty similar sometimes, but there are two distinct types of involuntary movements. A few ways to differentiate them are that tics are brief and sudden, whereas stimming or motor stereotypies tend to be prolonged. So somebody who is stimming might rock back and forth like this repetitively for several minutes, whereas someone who is ticking will do a brief jerk. They also persist during times of intense focus, whereas tics tend to subside during intense focus. Tics also have something called a premonitory urge, which is this internal physical or sometimes mental sensation that lets you know the tic is about to happen, and it will remain there and make you uncomfortable until you've done the tic, and then that sensory feeling will go away. Stereotypies do not have this premonitory urge. Both stereotypies and tics will increase with stress or large emotions, and the person may have trouble controlling either one. Another factor that can make people assume that autism spectrum disorder causes tics is the comorbidity rates between tic disorders and autism. Research has shown that about 22% of autistic people meet the diagnostic criteria for either Tourette syndrome or chronic tic disorder. The opposite is also true. About 21% of people with Tourette syndrome meet the diagnostic criteria for autism spectrum disorder. This means that a lot of autistic people have tics, and they may incorrectly attribute it to their autism, when in reality it's the effect of a comorbid tic disorder. Comorbid or comorbidity just means that there are two or more disorders present in the same person, and oftentimes this word is used when discussing the relationship between two disorders and how if you have one, you're more likely to have the other one. As of right now, there is nothing to suggest that there is a causal relationship between these disorders. That means that autism is not causing someone to have Tourette syndrome, and Tourette syndrome is not necessarily causing someone to have autism spectrum disorder, though Tourette syndrome does cause many of the same symptoms as autism, which leads to a lot of Tourette people meeting the diagnostic criteria for autism when it's really just the symptoms of their Tourette syndrome. But current research does not support the idea that autism causes people to have tics. Autism spectrum disorder does not cause tics, but there are several factors that can cause it to be confused for doing so. This includes motor stereotypies, which can look outwardly very similar to tics, being common in people with autism, and also the comorbidity rates between the two disorders, making it so that a lot of autistic people also have tics from a comorbid tic disorder. I hope this video was helpful for you, and if you're interested in more autism or Tourette syndrome related content, make sure you subscribe and turn on your notifications so you know as soon as I post those videos. I'm going to be posting more videos for Autism Awareness Month, and Tourette Syndrome Awareness Month is coming up May 15th to June 15th, and I'll be posting lots of videos for that as well. Thanks for watching. Bye.